Hi, Kerry here from My Quick Bookkeeping. It's often difficult to know which GST or HST code you should be using when you're preparing invoices for your customers or when you're entering the transactions for your expenses into QuickBooks. I think over the years I've given some conflicting advice to different people, so I thought today I'd make a video and we'd just clear it all up once and for all. If you're registered for GST or HST, then normally you're just going to be charging your basic GST or HST rate on all of your invoices. Here are examples of items that are taxable. The typical items you'd buy at a shop, such as clothing and footwear. Also, legal and accounting services, and lots of junk food. Some items are considered zero rated. This is different from exempt. For example, when I provide my services to a client in Canada, they're taxable. But when I work for people in the US, they're zero rated, or taxable at 0%. Other examples are the grocery items that most of us would be familiar with. An important distinction here is that if your services are zero rated, you can still claim input tax credits on the expenses that you incur in order to earn that income. So typically most of the expenses in running your business, the GST on them can then be claimed back. So that's if you're charging GST or if things are zero rated. Exempt supplies do not have GST or HST charged on them regardless of who the customer is. Examples include childcare, medical services, and residential accommodation. This means that if you run a daycare, for example, you'll not be claiming any GST credits. In fact, I would recommend not turning on the sales tax in QuickBooks at all. The last code that you'd be familiar with is the out-of-scope code. This is when you're entering a transaction that has nothing at all to do with the sales tax system. Maybe you're transferring some funds between your business and yourself, or you're paying your credit card bill. Typically, anytime you're moving things between balance sheet accounts and they don't hit the income statement is where you're going to be using that O out of scope code. In order to determine if the particular goods and services that you're offering in your business are subject to GST or HST, it's important you get advice from your accountant who's familiar with your business and exactly what it is that you're doing. Once you've worked that out, then you can apply what we've just covered in recording the transactions in QuickBooks. If you have everything recorded correctly in QuickBooks, you'll know that you've collected the right amount of GST, and I'm sure most of you are most concerned about collecting back all of those input tax credits that you've paid. If you have any questions about QuickBooks, not GST, do reach out. You can book a consultation below. You can send me an email. My website address is down there. While you're down there, click like, subscribe to my channel. There's a month-end checklist that you can download. I'm not even sure if that says to file a GST return. I should check that because that's something that needs to be done regularly, usually monthly, quarterly, or annually. Once again, your accountant will be able to help you with that. If there's anything else you'd like to know, please do make a note in the comments box. My next video could be for you. Cheers.